The Pens and the Bolts in the fourth and final meeting, the last non-divisional game for the Pittsburgh Penguins. And it'll be presented in FSN high definition by A&L Motors. And it'll be Jordan Staal taking the opening draw against Vinny LeCavalier, who's got 7 goals in his last 5 games. Scored a pair last night for Tampa Bay. They were up 4-1 and blew that lead. Lost 7-4, 6 goals by the Sabres in the third period. So they are coming off a very, very heartbreaking and embarrassing loss, and we'll see how they respond here tonight against the Penguins. There's a shot by St. Louis, who's also hot right now, and the save made by Marc-Andre Fleury. And Marian Hossa able to lift that puck back up into the Tampa Bay zone. And the big goaltender of the Lightning, Mike Smith, moves it along to the near side, where it's sent ahead by Alex Picard. The length of the ice, Brooks Orpik back to make the touch, and a chance for Bobby to tell us about the goaltenders.
Well, there's Marc-Andre Fleury shut out this Tampa Bay squad on March 4th, 35 saves in that win. 13-9-1, the save percentage is moving on up. This guy, he is a tall man. Talk about moving on up. Mike Smith, 6'2.5", 220. Great at handling the puck. 6 assists in his career, 3 this season. He got his first as a Lightning goaltender the other night.
9th appearance for Smith for the Lightning. He's 3-5 with a 2.39 goals against average for Tampa Bay. Here are the Penguins coming to center, and Evgeny Malkin moves it ahead to Peter Sikora, who didn't practice yesterday. He's been nursing and ailing back. Smith loves to move that puck, and he snaps it up the right wing, where it's taken by former Capital and Dallas star Jeff Halpern, who always plays well against the Penguins. We get a whistle and an offside call. Halpern, by the way, with 4 goals in his last 5 games. Michael Therrien pretty sure that his team's going to bounce back with a solid performance here tonight.
Yeah, very interesting to see. You know, the home coach has got the opportunity to put his starting lineup on the ice after the visiting coach, Tortorella, put his top unit out. Then Staal went out against that top unit. So you see a lot of line matching early in this hockey game. Malkin went out. Then you saw Halpern's line go out for Tampa. So both of these clubs starting it off already, Staggy. A lot of line matching.
Penguins go D to D, Whitney to Sador. And now the puck off a stick and back into the Lightning zone. And Philip Kuba will take the back pass and bank it ahead. Matthew Darche can't flag it down. And back up into the Penguins zone it goes. Sador back to get it. No icing on that play, but the Lightning have just been throwing the puck up into the Penguins zone here. Out of the corner, taken by Andreas Karlsson, who winds it around to the near side. Pinching in is Alex Picard to keep play alive, and he does. He works into the corner. Headed towards the net is former Penguin Michel Ouellette. In deep on the play, Picard. Kubo seems to have hurt himself. He's going back to the bench. And that's Darche. Matthew Darche.
He's cut right under the lipstick. You look at the Whitney had one hand on his stick. He tried to play the puck on the wall. I think his stick came up, hit Darche in the mouth.
Darche was covering the point there for Alex Picard, and he skated over to the bench, bent over after being cut.
Get over.
Now it's dumped in by the Penguins. Yarko Ruutu to the corner. Tyler Kennedy after it. Kennedy left it there for Max Talbot. Back for Tyler Kennedy. Penguins completing a change. Ryan Malone comes onto the ice now. Ryan Malone in the high slot. Philip Kuba busts around Max Talbot to get to the puck. Around Malone now, and it's backhanded ahead by Craig McDonald. Again, the length of the ice and another icing call here against Tampa Bay. I think that's 3 already against the Lightning as we see Matthew Darche being attended to on the bench.
And we'll take a look. Whitney's going to try to play this puck with one hand on a stick. There he pickle stabs it, and the stick comes up and just clips Darche right in the chops. He's getting attended to right now. No worse for wear. Looks like he'll be ready to go, and both officials missed that one. I could clearly see it from where I was standing, Staggy.
Bobby's wearing a suit tonight, though, not a striped jersey. Puck up to the near corner, and Evgeny Malkin with it to the right point to Letang. His shot off a stick, floating around there, around the net, and Sikora poked it towards the goal, and the save made by Smith. Sikora gets it back. Ian Malone and Malkin working the corner. Sikora looks for Malkin going to the net, couldn't get it through. Good defensive play by Alex Picard, and he headmans to Nick Tarnaski. Puck dumped to the corner where it's going to be taken by number 29, Craig McDonald. He's punished on the play beautifully by Chris Letang, who took the puck and quickly headmans to Ryan Malone. Left wing to Evgeny Malkin. Malkin drops it off for Malone, who pushes it to the corner for Malkin. He and Malone continue to try to maintain possession. Malone's got it behind the cage. Gonchar at the right point, looking for that puck to come his way, and it does. And he shoots it right back down below the goal line. And right there is Sikora, but it's poked away from him to the far boards by Junior Lessard. And wound back around to the near side where Gonchar will get to it. Gonchar sends it back behind the net for Evgeny Malkin. Malkin looks for Sikora, can't get it through. These guys have been on the ice a while. We have a newcomer on the ice now, and Pascal Dupuis. Malkin's upended, no penalty called. He'll need to get to the bench. He's got to be dog tired right now as Lessard dumps it all the way into the Penguin zone and goes to the bench himself.
That fourth line of the Tampa Bay Lightning doing a great job, as they did last time in this building when Andre Roy, the ex-Penguin, had 3 points in that one.
Jordan Staal tried a shot. It was blocked. He got it back. Now he works the corner. Marian Hossa on the ice as well. And Staal for Hossa. Went right under his stick as he was cutting to the goal. Taken by number 39, Mike Lundin. And he'll move it in behind the net to rookie Matt Smaby, who played for the Norfolk Admirals, just called up. Vinny LeCavalier down the wing. Smaby played with Sidney Crosby at Shattuck St. Mary's. Also, Drew Stafford of the Buffalo Sabres played with those two guys. So he's a former teammate of Sid's. Lead pass now to Marty St. Louis. Into the Penguin zone. Drops it off for LeCavalier. He tried to angle one to the net. He was looking for a man cutting that way. Looking for a Juuse Jokinen, but it didn't come through. And the Penguins counterattack. Tape with a shot. And a save made by Mike Smith. And he pins it against that logo.
Well, Tafe got that puck down the right side. He's a left-handed shooter. And three Penguins drove the cage as we take a look at tonight's PNC Bank lines. The Staal unit starting the hockey game. Malkin came on after that. Some matchup, certainly. Staal will go against LeCavalier. Malkin will go against the defensive unit of the Tampa Bay Lightning. Stag, I'm looking at Talbot and Tafe, and I'm looking at the defensive pairings. Everybody's pretty solid. I noticed Rob Scuderi was in warm-ups tonight. I think you might see him in the lineup on Saturday. And, of course, it's Halpern that's going to be checking. One of the newest members from that Dallas trade will be checking again in Malkin tonight.
Daryl Sador, former Lightning. Is it along for Ryan Whitney? Penguins are crisply moving that puck out of their own zone right now. And dumped into the Lightning zone. The Lightning will not trap. They will not make it difficult for the Penguins in the neutral zone. Their success comes from forcing the Penguin defense in their end if they can do it. And if the Penguins are moving the puck like that past their first two forwards, Bob, Penguins are going to get a lot of speed through center ice here tonight against Tampa Bay.
Well, I think so. I think, you know, the Penguins have to use their speed through there, Staggy. But, you know, Tampa's playing. I think they're going to try to tighten it up. Here comes Ouellette, plus 12 on the year.
Ouellette shoots the puck. It's blocked. He gets it back. Tried to drop it off. He did, but it came right to Tyler Kennedy, and he springs the man up the right wing. Maxime Talbot cuts inside, outside on Alex Picard. Picard knocks him down as he tried to make one more move around him. And the Lightning counterattack. Matthew Darche back on the ice after getting cut. Now Ouellette is punished on the near boards by Hal Gill. And Chris Letang with a beautiful move around McDonald, but he couldn't headman the puck past Darche, who chops it back up into the Penguin zone.
Darche's stick got right up into the face of Ruutu right in front of me, Staggy. So an inadvertent high stick by Darche on Ruutu, who didn't take too kindly to that.
Now the Penguins attack, and it's Dupuis firing in his block. He gets trying to get his own rebound. But Juuse Jokinen moves it ahead of Marty St. Louis, who drags the puck around Hal Gill and try to go underneath him. And that's about the only way that St. Louis is going to beat Hal Gill, right? Just burrow right underneath him. That was a backhand shot taken by Jokinen off the side of the cage, and Hal Gill right there to take it. Hal Gill a minus four in his first three games, a plus seven in his last six for the Penguins, playing well alongside of Chris Letang. Ed Manning the puck now is Matt Smaby to center. Penguins break it up. Fourth line on. Chris Menard can't handle the puck. Smaby moves it to his partner. And out to Nick Tarnaski now. And he'll double to the right wing corner. And here comes that forecheck of the Lightning. But Fleury moving the puck quickly to Gonchar. And out the Penguins come. Very quickly, Connor James moves it up the wall. Good back pressure, though, as Carlson got back in good defensive position to break up the Penguins' rush. And now the Lightning quickly move it out of their own zone. The Lightning appear to have a lot more jump here tonight. Their pride was definitely injured last night in that loss to the Buffalo Sabres.
Certainly was. Dan Boyle, who's pursuing the puck right now, talked about that, said it was embarrassing. And for Boyle, it has been kind of an embarrassing season.
Here's Malone trying to come to the goal. He's upended, but there'll be no penalty on the play as Smith freezes the puck.
Well, the advantage of being down here, Staggy, I'm right in the middle of the action and loving it.
Well, Bob Berry just told you that Rob Scuderi was on the ice for warm-ups tonight, but guess what? He was also on the ice this morning during the team's morning skate. The defenseman who fractured his pinky on February 26th had the pin removed in that pinky yesterday and said he felt pretty good. In fact, his grip's okay, his conditioning is there, but there has been no timetable set for his return. However, guys, considering he was practicing this morning and again tonight, I guess the exploding pinky is almost ready to go. Back to you.
Yeah, thanks, Dan. You talk about exploding. When you take the pin out of a bomb, what does it do? It's ready to explode. He took the pin out of his finger, and he's ready to play pretty soon.
Ryan Malone moving in. Malone checked by Ouellette, drops it off. Malkin's shot blocked, and Malkin goes after the puck behind the goal. Malkin, Sikora, and Malone on the ice. And Malkin held scoreless for only the fifth time since Sidney Crosby was injured the other night in New York. On the doorstep trying to jam it home, but a great poke check by Mike Smith just as Malkin was ready to pull the trigger. Now Sikora fans on the puck, and it comes back to Philip Kuba. He moves it along for Alex Picard, acquired from the Flyers at the trading deadline for Vinny Prospel. Picard over to Kuba. And Kuba, the former Minnesota Wild, moves it on left wing for Matthew Darche. He pokes into the Penguin zone. A good look for Sidor as he surveyed the entire ice and then moved it to his partner, Ryan Whitney. That's because the Lightning were changing. And he wanted to get a good look at what was up ahead. Now it's back to Ryan Whitney again in his own zone. To Jordan Staal, nice little pass to Marian Hossa. Hossa with a strong stride down the wing, trying to get around Shane O'Brien. Hossa turns the corner and leaves it for Pascal Dupuis. And now Dupuis trying to poke it to the point to Brooks Orpik, who's got to back out. Puck stays in the Lightning zone. And controlled by O'Brien, Hossa trying to steal it away from him. And the Lightning's, the Cavalier can't get it out. Dupuis tees it up, doesn't shoot it, drops it off to Hossa. Hossa trying to come to the net, backhands one in front. Off the skate of the defenseman, Shane O'Brien. Now St. Louis tries to get it out. Penguins won't let them do that. Gonchar to Dupuis. The Lightning having a tough time. They're fumbling around with that puck in their own zone, and the Penguins could make them pay here. Here's Gonchar. Goes left side to Orpik. Orpik's wrist shot is stopped. Goes in behind the net. Stalls after it. So is Dan Boyle. He's reaching in there trying to get the puck. The two-on-two battle is won by Dan Boyle, and he finds Vinny LeCavalier. The Cavalier's lead pass all the way up into the Penguin zone.
Anytime you keep the top unit of Tampa hemmed in their own zone, you're doing a great job. That was great work by Hossa, Dupuis, and Staal. Dupuis with six assists in his last three hockey games.
Lightning giving the puck away in their own end to the Penguins. Now Maxime Talbot takes it behind the cage. Tyler Kennedy pops it free to the near side, and there's Letang with a great anticipation, moving it down the wall. But then Nick Tarnaski able to move the puck back to center. Gill quickly fires it right back into the Lightning zone. Now it's Letang on the near wall again. Again, the Penguins trying to keep them bottled up, but they'll finally get the puck to center. Tarnaski swinging wide and dumping it in. This line dumps it in every time. Get in on the forecheck. Number 42 is Junior Lessard, Andreas Carlson, and Nick Tarnaski.
That's not a bad thing. Know your limitations, Staggy. They just get it deep and go to work.
That's what they're doing right now. Now Matthew Darche comes onto the ice. Maxime Talbot knocked down on the corner. Lessard tried to come to the net. Talbot recovers to pick his pocket. Talbot goes down again. Every time you look at Talbot in the corners battling, you think of that high ankle sprain. He is gutting it out right now for the Penguins. There's a shot by Kuba, steered away by Fleury to the corner. And
too many men. Oh, it's too many men on the ice. Well, that touched that puck. Lessard and Carlson still on the ice, and the whole Penguin bench is standing up right now. Dvorsky says, oh, I didn't see it.
The whistles have not been used in this game so far. As the puck comes in behind the net, Craig McDonald will take it behind the cage. McDonald looks in front. Now Darche will step behind the net, throws it in front, and a shot. Save made by Fleury on Michel Ouellette, who was in his favorite spot right on the front porch. But Fleury back to the goal line made the save. Back in a moment, no score with 9:20 to go in the first.
Thanks to Network. Well, Mike, tough exchange there. It looked like too many men on the ice for Tampa.
That go to the discretion of the referee. He could have called it. Puck stayed in her own end. We turned the puck over at her blue line, and we had a penalty. So the detail of the game at this time of the year are really important and crucial. We try to focus on that.
All right, thanks, Mike.
Ryan Whitney in the box for holding, and the Lightning put their power play to work. It's been pretty good lately. They've got five power play goals in their last four games, and their power play is ranked seventh, fourth at home, 22nd on the road. So they haven't been as efficient away from home. Here's Boyle firing, and the save made by Fleury. And Dan Boyle makes a big difference. Yep. He's got 7 points in his last seven games.
Flip side of that, the Penguins have killed 26 of the last 27 on home ice, and there's Staal dogging Boyle. Okay.
Penguins are ranked sixth at home in the National Hockey League in penalty killing. An amazing number, especially when you look at what they're ranked on the road. We talk about it. 28th on the road and sixth at home. And Jordan Staal with that swagger on home ice, killing penalties. Trying to do it himself here, but he's stripped of the puck by Boyle, and Kuba takes over for Tampa Bay. Philip Kuba rushes the puck right up the middle of the ice. Gains the offensive zone and moves it to Vinny LeCavalier. LeCavalier has St. Louis open, doesn't go that way. Boyle looking for the puck, but LeCavalier works it to St. Louis in the corner. In front of the net is Jussi Jokinen for the Lightning. Vinny has the puck again. St. Louis moves to the point. Boyle moves down into the slot. St. Louis fires and it's blocked, and the Penguins get it. Dupuis skates that puck out, but not all the way out. He'll try now, and he shoots it up into the bench on the far side.
Steggy, it's not on the bench. It's right in my hand.
Oh, really? Oh,
thanks. Yes, thanks.
Oh, okay, well, it came through the bench right to Bob Airy. Good catch, Bob.
And I'm going to throw it over the glass.
By the way, Dan Potash and I have another edition of Inside Penguins Hockey on Saturday night at 6:30 right here on FSN. It will be Jarkko Ruutu and Jeff Tate on the show. You're going to like it. It's good stuff.
Yeah, you talked about Pascal trying to carry that puck over. He had a good foot speed there, some good hop in his stride, but you got to get the puck out, killing the penalty. He wasn't too happy, but Talbot gives him a tap, says, let's just keep killing.
Alex Pekar moves it right side. Shot taken and blocked by Fleury on the shot by Andreas Karlsson, and he will hold on to it, and we'll get a faceoff to the left of the Flower.
I sense a lot of urgency in this game, and rightfully so. I mean, you know, Tampa, they have really nothing to play for but pride, but jobs in the National Hockey League. And Marc-Andre Fleury makes a great glove save through a screen. And the Pittsburgh Penguins need all the points they can get. This one is not going to be easy. The Tampa Bay Lightning have won the last seven meetings between these two clubs on Penguin ice.
Clean faceoff win on the power play, and the shot taken by Picard. Lunging for it was Fleury. Couldn't catch it. It goes to the corner, and Orpik right there to send it down the ice. Boy, Michel Therrien very, very effusive in his praise of Brooks Orpik today when we asked about him at the morning press conference with Michel Therrien. An offside call on the Lightning. He talked about how Orpik has really taken advantage of the extra responsibility playing alongside of Sergei Gonchar. Bob, with Scuderi out of the lineup, said that he's not looking to hit people. He's waiting for guys to come to him, really playing within himself, and he gave him all the credit for how he's been able to improve his game with the extra ice time.
So a pat on the back. I mean, you know, sometimes it's a little more than that for Michel Therrien, but everybody needs a pat on the back now and then, including Brooks Orpik, who indeed is playing some great hockey right now. The Penguins worked on that defensive play you talked about, not trying to get over-aggressive, trying to be in position. Yesterday's practice was involved with back-checking, knowing your assignments on the back-check, and in-zone coverage, knowing exactly who's got who.
Here's Evgeny Malkin. Why not? There were a couple of wide-open Rangers the other night, right, Bob? Sean Avery. I mean, that's a good time to drive that message home when you have a game like that, like the Penguins had in New York.
Yep, and they had the opportunity to do that. That's great to have those off days late in the season.
Letang's shot hits the side of the cage. Lightning failing to score on the power play. The Penguins have three shots in the game, six for Tampa Bay. And Lassard guns one wide of the goal. Tarnaski chips it towards the corner. Malkin cleans up his own zone. He has been phenomenal deep in his own end, playing that center ice position like a third defenseman back there. Here's Malkin again, swooping in. His backhander through the slot. And Tarnaski tries to clear. Good stick by Sador, but then Tarnaski with a second crack at it, able to push it up into the Penguin zone.
The Malkin line was held off the board against the New York Rangers. Love to get on the board here tonight against Tampa. And LeCavalier St. Louis on the ice for Tampa Bay. Vinny LeCavalier was 0 points in three outings against Pittsburgh this year.
Tyler Kennedy has control. Kennedy used the window to get it inside the Lightning zone. It comes right back to him. He tried to throw it to the net, and it was blocked by Picard, who lost his stick in the process. He'll pick it up as the Penguins go to the point. Gonchar, that nifty skating that he does laterally at the blue line. Here he is again. Gonchar getting himself free down the left wing. Moved it back. Now it'll come to Orpik, and a slap shot. Kicked out by Scott. Rebound. Score! Jarkko Ruutu scores. I think he might have taken a stick in the face. He did. He's cut. But he's got a goal, and the Penguins lead it 1-0.
Yeah, they got to take a look at this right now. The linesmen, all four officials are together. Ruutu was chopped in the face as he put that big fat rebound off the pads of Mike Smith into the cage. Watch this, setting the table. Talbot to Orpik. He just gets it on the net. That's all it takes. And Ruutu following up, gets his stick on the puck before Dan Boyle does. Dan Boyle now is a minus 18 on the season. he signed a big fat contract because he can put offensive numbers up, but he talked about being embarrassed. Well, it was his stick that gets into the stick, into the mouth of Ruutu. Now, Rutu's a tough guy, but he's not a beaver, Steg, and he wasn't trying to eat wood there.
And he looks around. He's looking for a penalty after scoring the goal. And I'll tell you, that was a beautiful rebound opportunity after a great shot by Brooks Orpik from the point.
Yeah, just get it on net, eh, Steggy? I mean, how many times do you say that? You're not really shooting to score from down there. You're shooting to get some kind of advantage, and that was a big fat rebound off Smith's pads. Look at that. I mean, great job there. Great job by Ruutu to drive to the front of the cage, and the Penguins got on every loose puck in the offensive zone.
So the Penguins have taken the 1-0 lead on home ice, where they have been rolling. They're 14-2-3 in their last 19 at home. And that first goal is gigantic, especially against a team that had a meltdown in the third period last night. But in fairness to the Lightning, they had won three in a row prior to last night's game, and they did have a 4-1 lead, after all, on the road against the Buffalo Sabres, so they won't be easy to put away here tonight. Yep. Andreas Carlson dumps the puck in.
And they're on a power play, the Penguins right now. Boyle, two-minute high-sticking penalty on that goal by Ruutu, so the Penguins can put another notch here in the coffin if they can. Another nail in the coffin, if you will. They can get Tampa down by two.
And they go to work in the corner. Quick pass to the point. Gonchar, left side to Whitney. Whitney to Gonchar. One-timer. Fires it wide. And it comes off the boards right to Philip Kubo, who rifles it off the window and all the way back up into the Penguin zone.
Yeah, be careful. Seven shorthanded goals by Tampa.
Quick pass by Fleury to Malkin. Four Lightning players were back anyway. Malkin under pressure from LeCavalier. Backhands it to the corner. Sikora reaching around. And the centering pass for Malkin out of his reach. And LeCavalier, dangerous shorthanded. Comes back with Craig McDonald. Trailing in the play is Shane O'Brien. Vinny fires. Save made. Rebound. Oh, another save by Fleury on the rebound opportunity for Shane O'Brien, who was following on. As Fleury gave up the big rebound on the shot by Vinny LeCavalier.
Yeah, and that assist by Talbot on that goal by Ruutu. That ties a career high. Talbot, 24 points on the season.
Letang turns his back to the defender so he can backhand it in behind the goal. 30 seconds to go on the penalty to Dan Boyle. Poked away by Smith, but it pops right back into his glove, and he holds on to it. Time for our Geico quote of the day.
That man, Mike Yeo, on that man, Ryan Malone. He's been a huge part of everything we've accomplished the last couple of years, and you don't win games consistently the way we have without guys doing the little things that he does. He goes to the front of the net. He fights when he has to. He can score goals. Ryan Malone is having a career year.
24 goals, 45 points coming into the game tonight, and he's got 15 goals, 15 assists, 30 points in his last 32 hockey games. And an offside call on the Penguins with 9 seconds remaining on the penalty to Dan Boyle. How about Jarkko Ruutu, Bob? It's like the classic scenario for him. He scores a goal and gets a bloody nose in the process. I mean, he's the perfect guy to have that happen. I mean, you don't want to see that happen to anybody, but if it's going to happen to somebody, it might as well be Jarkko Ruutu.
Yeah, Jarkko Ruutu has really been getting involved and really been getting his face dirty, I guess you could say, Staggy, because he's at his best when he does that. You know, the goal is just a bonus, I think. You know, he's getting involved physically. He gets into the heads of the opponents, and I really think he's going to prove to be, well, he's going to prove to be huge in the playoffs. If the Penguins go far, they're going to need Jarkko Ruutu.
Gonchar's shot sticked away by Kubo, and Jarkko Ruutu has a goal in each of his last two games for that beautiful backhander on a breakaway against Lundqvist the other night in New York, and now he beats Mike Smith on a bang-bang play in front off a rebound. Dan Boyle back on the ice, shoots it in, and Fleury stops it behind the goal. Marc-Andre Fleury toying with the puck a little bit. LeCavalier came in. Now it's moved to the far boards, and there's Orpik again. I think Orpik has the tools to be a really, really good defenseman in this league because of his wheels. He's just a great, powerful skater. And the more he learns to play his position, and I think that the better chance he's going to have to take full advantage of the tools that he does have.
I agree, Stig. He maybe doesn't like the pains that he's gone through with Michael Therrien. It's only going to make him a better player, a more complete player, and a player that's going to play in the National Hockey League for a long time.
Here's Sikora gunning one. Deflected. Oh, my goodness. Twice, including by the defenseman, Matt Smeby. Almost put it in his own goal. Well, Ruutu paid a dear price, but he gave the Penguins a 1-0 lead.
Well, we talked about Max Talbot, career high, and he matched with 24 points. Evgeny Malkin, 97 points on the season. a career high. And Ryan Malone, you talked about that, Staggy. What a terrific year he's had. Ty Conklin, 18 wins, surpassed 17, which was his high before that. And we, you know, Shane Heyer, the linesman, came over to me, said, "Bobby, do you know that rule?" And I said, "Yeah, the penalty." And I told him, I said, "Hey, it would have been a four-minuter had the Penguins not scored. It would have been a four-minute high stick on Boyle, that high stick against the face of Jarkko Ruutu. But the puck went in the net. That wiped off one of the two-minute minors. Consequently, only 2 minutes went on the board."
Here's Hossa turning now for Staal, and I think Picard got a stick in there at the last second to prevent Staal from pulling the trigger. So Shane Heyer came over, and then Bob asked another question. Bob, you followed it up, and what was that question?
I said, "What if the high stick was after the goal went in the net?" He goes, "Well, we would have had to seen it then." So I don't know if they saw it or not. But yeah, they got it right. I think they probably got it right. We'll have to take one more look and see if the high stick was before the puck went in or after the puck went in.
1:55 remaining in the first period. We all know this. The puck went in, and it's 1-0 Pittsburgh. And the Lightning have 8 shots, and the Penguins have 6. And the Pens certainly are happy to be on top in this hockey game. A goal from an unlikely source, too, and Jarkko Ruutu hit there on Letang. Centering pass, loose puck. Shane O'Brien takes it. And O'Brien backing off so he can wrist it in behind the net. Ouellette there trying to center it. Loose puck again. And Ouellette gets another crack at it. Moves it out to the point to O'Brien. Michel Ouellette has played well. He's got 8 goals in his last 12 games. Here he is again shooting. I think Fleury got a piece of that to make a save on Ouellette. Now back come the Pens, and Tate gains the red line and dumps it in and then goes to the bench.
Ouellette, he could put the puck in the net. You remember when he played alongside Malkin last year, he found a lot of those Malkin passes, was a recipient, and put him in the cage, and he's been a plus player, not only with the Penguins, but a plus 12 in Tampa. Those are lofty totals on this club.
I remember when he was in Pittsburgh, and here's Malkin centering one. Malone takes control of it beautifully, gives some ground there, trying to open some space for himself, threw it to the net, and it's knocked down. Remember last year, I know there were a lot of folks who thought that Michel Therrien was kind of playing favorites by playing Ouellette a lot when he wasn't scoring. And the fact of the matter is, he watched video of every game that Ouellette played, and he liked the way he played defensively. He could rely on it. When you look at his numbers in Tampa, and it's the same thing. And the guy's a good hockey player. Here's a shot from a sharp angle by Sikora, and the save made by Smith. And behind the net is Shane O'Brien, and he'll move it out. Tarnaski reaches for it, and the bouncing puck moved back up into the Penguins' zone.
The Penguins will get their stalled unit on the ice with Hossa and Dupuis.
Now, look at Hossa. Those first two steps, he can separate himself from people with those two strides. As we take another look at the goal, Bob, to see, did the puck go in first, before the high stick, or after?
And of course, you know, it all depends on when they saw it as well. So there's the high stick almost simultaneously as that puck crosses the goal line. And then the referees get together. So probably a pretty good call, Staggy. Probably a pretty good call.
Orpik drives it in. Picard gave it away. Hossa with a quick shot. Blocker save made by Smith. Hossa got rid of that shot in a hurry. And now Gonchar fires it in, but not before the green light came on. The folks standing behind the goal, but time had expired. You could hear the horn as Gonchar was releasing the shot. So the Penguins will go to the locker room with a 1-0 lead, not a 2-0 lead. But certainly feeling pretty good after a solid first period of hockey.
Yeah, definitely no argument from either club. I think Dupuis may have redirected that as we look at the clock. And there it expires, and the puck goes by Smith. Smith did not even see it. Just heard it, Staggy.
And let's take a look at our Fort Pitt Capital by the numbers first period recap, and you see that the shots were even once the full 20 minutes was in the books.
Pretty even period of hockey, I thought. And Marc-Andre Fleury with some good glove saves against Tampa on their power play. But the Penguins are able to capitalize on the Ruutu rebound.
Brooks Orpik was the one who created that rebound, and he'll be talking with Dan Potash in just a moment. Bob Aries, Hockey 101 on the ingredients of a Stanley Cup champion, highlights and analysis. It's all coming up in just a moment as the Penguins have a 1-0 lead over Tampa Bay. Penguins drew first blood in this game, literally. Scoring the goal, and then this blood of Jarkko Ruutu spilling after he put the puck in the net. The Penguins leading 1-0 on his fourth of the year, and wasn't as pretty as the goal he scored the other night. A against the New York Rangers, but with Jarkko Ruutu, it doesn't really matter. He'll take him any way he can get him.
No, Matthew Darche, he got clipped by the high stick of Whitney as well earlier in that period. And the Penguins haven't won on home ice since November 2nd, 2002, against this Tampa Bay Hockey Club. So I don't expect Tampa Bay is going to go away easily in this one either. They're looking to be a spoiler.
Well, John Tortorella and Michelle Therrien had some words as they went off the ice at the end of the period. I don't know if you saw that or if you, maybe it wasn't a heated conversation. I think it was Tortorella maybe making reference to the fact that the Penguins got away with a high-sticking penalty and the Lightning didn't. Now the puck in the Penguin zone as they try to get it out. It's Marian Hossa. Couldn't reach it. Gonchar will take it and snap it up the near side for Pascal Dupuis. Philip Kuba held it in, backhanding it to Le Cavalier. Dish pass, a beauty to St. Louis. He centers one, cleared by Gonchar. Ooh, a crash over there on the far board.
It's
going hit. Down
That's
with Dupuis.
Delayed penalty right now.
Dupuis taking the man out. Tarnaski on the play. Or was that Kuba? And that was Kuba that was upended by Dupuis. As the Lightning are on the attack, they get the extra attacker on. St. Louis dishes it down deep, but Dorpik there to take it and draw the whistle.
Pascal Dupuis had a team high, 6 hits in the last game. And now he's got gonna have to go to the penalty box. A little overzealous, apparently.
That was an incidental contact, Bob. I don't even look like there was really a penalty there. Just looked like Kuba tripped over the skates of Dupuis. To me, from that replay, anyway.
I didn't get a good look at it, Staggy, so I cannot comment other than the fact that he's sitting in the box and the penalty's. And the Penguins are going to have to kill this penalty.
Yes, they are. And the Lightning are 0 for 1 with 3 shots on their first power play chance. You know, the Lightning have the fewest number of power play opportunities in the NHL, second fewest number of times shorthanded. So they've spent the least amount of time on special teams of any team in the NHL. Carlson with it on the near wall. Gives it down low. Centering pass. Willett with a quick shot off the stick and then off the side of the cage. Al Gill out here trying to kill the penalty along with Chris Letang as the puck comes to the near boards. Carlson wanted to pass it to the point, but there was nobody home. Boyle had moved into the middle, so he'll have to go back into his own zone to play it. Dupuis in the box for another minute 24 as the Lightning get this power play on track. It's Andreas Carlson leaving it for Dan Boyle. A dangerous offensive defenseman loses the puck. And now Orpik will look up and find an opening and shoot it all the way down the ice.
Jordan Staal killing a penalty for the Penguins right now. If you had asked me at this time of the season, would he have 0 shorthanded goals? I would have said, you got to be kidding me. Well, Jordan Staal has not scored a shorthanded goal this season after that terrific season last year.
7 year ago, and here's a chance now against Picard. And he's got Hossa coming with him. Staal pulls up. Oh, he was just ready to pull the trigger and fanned on it.
Well,
and Picard snaps it out. Yes, it would have been good timing, Bob. And here's Le Cavalier with it. Le Cavalier turning and moving it to the right point to Dan Boyle. He's got an opening. Just a shot pass there for St. Louis to Le Cavalier. Centering pass, Jokinen fanned on the redirect attempt. And Picard with it for Jokinen. Former Dallas star moves it out to the point. Picard to Boyle. Le Cavalier a one-timer. Off the stick of Brooks Orpik and wide of the goal. Le Cavalier can't play it. Malone took it away, trying to force it out. Didn't get it all the way out. Le Cavalier to St. Louis to Jokinen. And instead of shooting the puck, he tried to go back to St. Louis. And it's broken up by Gonchar, but he didn't get it out. Dumped right back to the near corner. Well, St. Louis will take it again with 8 seconds to go on the penalty. Le Cavalier has it center point to St. Louis. Back to Le Cavalier. St. Louis a one-timer, and Orpik again gets in the way of that. He did a good job on that penalty kill to block a couple of shots on those one-timers, but they still have the puck penalty over. Shot by Picard. Again, a good stick by Gonchar to knock it away, and now he's got it on his stick. Dupuis back on the ice. He crisscrosses with Gonchar. Gonchar crisscrossing again. Got a little confused there about who to pass the puck to and gave it right to the Lightning.
Now Orpik had a chance to clear there, but he had Ryan Malone's stick. After Orpik had lost the stick, Ryan Malone handed his off, and Orpik didn't clear it. Different curve.
Sikora with a drive. That blocked. And the Lightning counterattack. Pushed ahead by Carlson in behind the goal. Taken there by Fleury and right to Daryl Sador. And an easy out for the Penguins to center. But dumped right back in by Tampa Bay. Fleury sets it up for Sador. Turns away from the forechecker, Craig McDonald, and finds Peter Sikora. Tried to go east-west to Malkin, but it goes off a stick and up into the Lightning zone nevertheless. O'Brien moves it around for Kuba, couldn't take the pass. Junior Lessard hit hard by Ruutu from behind. That'll be a penalty on Jarkko Ruotsu.
Now the Lightning surround Jarkko Ruotsu. I don't know if any of them really saw it, although they know that Ruotsu was standing over the man, and Ruotsu will now go to the penalty box. Let's take a look at Junior Lessard getting knocked into the boards.
Oof.
Right off that turnbuckle.
It wasn't a direct hit from behind. It was a blindside hit, but it wasn't on the numbers, if you will. It was more from the side, but he caught him in such a way that his face went into the boards.
Not the turnbuckle, just the ledge of the boards, if you will, Steggy.
Mm-hmm. That's where Malone failed to get it out, and then the one pass too many, I think, as Jokinen had a chance to shoot it and try to go back across to Saint-Louis. The Lightning are 0 for 2 on the power play. They did not register a shot on that last one. They'll have another opportunity here with Ruotsu in the box. Dan Boyle missed 36 games after having a skate fall on him in the locker room and cut his arm. His wrist, he had surgery, and it's really nice to see him come back and have the production he's had, Bob. You always worry about whether or not that'll really affect a guy. Great save there by Florian Kuba. And a loose puck in front. Orbit couldn't clear it. Coming in with a shot, he scored. Fleury was down and lost his stick. He was flopping around, and the puck hit his body and caromed into the goal. So Vincent LeCavalier, with his 40th goal of the year, ties the game at one.
Now, Fleury did all he could, I mean, but he was like a worm in the crease. The puck is going back and forth, and LeCavalier gets his first point this season. Look at Marc-Andre Fleury. And he can only do so much. The puck's going left and right and left and right. He threw a stick out of the way. Thought that might give him an advantage to play that puck with his hands freely. Watch as the puck goes off Orpik back. Fleury's going to lose his footing. You know, a goalie can only go left and right so many times. And that indirect bounce off Orpik's skate really confused Fleury. He was unable to get back to his left. And LeCavalier was able to put one into that cage.
So Vinny finally finds the back of the net this season against the Penguins. He hadn't been able to score in the first three games between the two clubs. St. Louis and Kuba getting the assist. Now it's McDonald for Ouellette. And Ouellette handed it right to Evgeny Malkin. Now McDonald moves it down low again. Ouellette trying to center for Darsh, and it goes past him and all the way back into the Lightning zone.
We talked about the Lightning, the fact that they don't get on many special teams. I think you would want to if you have a seventh-ranked power play like Tampa does in the National Hockey League. You'd like to be in more penalty-filled games, I believe, and the penalty killing's right in the middle of the pack, so it'd be to their advantage to be in the games that were more highly penalized.
By the way, St. Louis is playing in his 600th game here tonight, Bob, and just wanted to make sure we mentioned that.
Yeah, he's got 502 points, Steg. I remember playing against him when he was in the minors, and I was finishing my career. I said, you'll never make it to the league. You'll never make it to the NHL. You're too small and blah, blah, blah. Well, look at him now. I was just trying to get under his skin. I was trying to pull a Ruotsu, Steg. It didn't quite work.
Well, the Calgary Flames traded them to the Lightning. They could have had them all this time. Puck sent back into the Penguins' zone. Fleury out of the net.
And the Flames got rid of Mark Savard and Rico Fatta and Corey Stillman. And they had a lot of young, talented hockey players that they bypassed.
A lot of good defensemen they've traded away, too, over the last few years. Mike Commodore being one of them. Here's Jordan Staal with it. Also, Jordan Leopold is another guy they traded. And a few others, too. Andrew Ference. Staal with it now. But they certainly still have a very good defense and a great team. Here's a shot by Gonchar that misses the goal. Mike Keenan doing a great job in Calgary this year.
Yes.
And they've got Jerome Iginla, too, who is certainly a candidate for the Hart Trophy as most valuable player in the NHL. Here's Ruotsu dishing it off for Hossa. Hossa turning away from Tarnaski. Marian Hossa strong down low. And he's going to bring it up high again for Orpik. Cross ice. And Ruotsu just pushes it behind the goal for Staal. Staal reaching out for it. Being dogged from behind by Tarnaski. This is a tough shift here for all the players involved. Staal with it. Centers and Dupuis shot in the fan out of it. Almost went in anyway. Now the Lightning have control. And it's LeCavalier counterattacking for the Bolts. And he'll knock it off the boards and up into the Penguins zone. Fleury stops it behind the net. 7 minutes gone by here in the second period. The game tied at one.
Nice feed there, Dupuis. We talked about him earlier. And we asked him about playing the off wing in his own end. He said, I don't have much of a curve on my stick, so it doesn't really hurt me too much when I'm playing on my backhand or forehand. Well, it hurt him there because he just barely got his stick on that puck, but a straight blade, he wasn't able to corral it with a curve. I think he may have been able to get that puck on the net.
Talbot hit hard by Andreas Carlson down low, but he continues to work. Talbot moves it to the point to Letang. Letang to Gill. Gill wrists it off the boards on purpose, and it takes a perfect bounce right to Max Talbot.
Oh, Kennedy got toppled in front of the net. Might have been a penalty there. Kuba got away with one.
Now St. Louis works his own zone. Over on the far side for Alex Picard. Just throws it rink wide. Not a good play. Ruutu throws it back to the net, and the save made by Smith. The rebound comes free for Kuba. He winds it around. Look at Letang in deep on the play. And now he's going to be trapped. He'll have to get back. He recovers extremely well. Ruutu helps him out here, cutting off Jokinen and neutralized. And the Penguins have control. That's one thing Hal Gill mentioned today, Bob, is Letang's ability to recover. And, of course, he watches the back door for him also.
Yeah, he said he's really impressed by Letang, not just offensively. He said he's got very good defensive skills. He can read plays, and that's the key.
Now the Lightning trying to make a play against Letang and Gill, and they get it right to the net. Darsh's shot stopped by Fleury on the short side. Craig McDonald shouldered by Letang. He turns away from that check, looks for Darsh. Good play by Tafe to work down low and pick off the pass. But it comes right back to Darsh. He centers, and right off the stick of Connor James and back up towards the Lightning zone. This is a good hockey game. These two teams are working extremely hard. There are some real battles going on in the offensive zones down low. And that's when you know teams have come to play, because that's a price that has to be paid when you're trying to generate offense in deep. Michel Ouellette after it. Fleury trying to get it away from him. Does. Up the right wing for Connor James. Connor James comes ahead. Gains the red line. Cuts into the middle here. And he'll dump it around in behind the net. Smith will stop it. Pushes it away from Connor James. And up the right wing boards to Michel Ouellette. Goes rink wide. And it'll be just dumped around the horn again. Fleury with a good play to stop it behind the net and right out to Ryan Malone. Malone delays for a moment. Instead of passing it directly to Sikori, feeds it to the opposite corner for him. Sikori in after it. Malkin got there. Moves it back to Whitney, who wrists it in deep. All the way up the near side for Daryl Sador. Off his stick to Sikora. Sikora trying to backhand it, but Philip Kuba has control. Kuba gave it away to Malkin behind the net. To Sikora, and he couldn't pull the trigger. Sador reaches out. It's a good play to keep it alive. Sikora with it again. Throws it right through the goal mouth. It was airborne, and Malkin couldn't knock it out of midair. Now Sador pays a price on the near boards as he's hit by Carl Stewart, that got the puck in deep again. Great forecheck by the Penguins. Lightning can't get out of their own zone. The fans are feeling it right now. They come to life here at Mellon Arena as the Penguins work their tails off. Another steal. Ryan Whitney closing in, goes left side. Malkin takes the pass, throws it in front. Broken up. Malkin gets it back. He scores! Gino roofs it to give the Penguins a 2-1 lead.
Well, you got to take a look at the hands of Malkin just to corral that pass from the point. The pass was to his backhand. He turned the hands over so quickly as he received that puck from the blue line down. Right there, gets it back, turns it over, and gets it high over Smith, who tries to get that right pad up. There, look at him take that pass initially. Kuba slides down. Puck comes right back to Malkin like a magnet. And Malkin's able to just loft that puck on the backhand right over top of the fallen Smith. And the Penguins have gone in front 2-1.
How long did that shift last in the offensive zone? And the reward was the goal for Evgeny Malkin as he lifted it up underneath the crossbar. And Bob Smith went through the same kind of thing that Fleury did at the other end, where the puck was changing direction in front of him, and he couldn't recover to make the save on Evgeny Malkin.
Well, you talked about paying a price and really moving your feet. Both of these teams have been paying a price, but the Penguins there are able to turn the puck over just with great pressure in the offensive zone.
Now it's Tarnaski on the left wing. He slaps one to the goal. Good save made, and Fleury holds onto it with 9:31 to go in the second period. Evgeny Malkin brings the crowd to its feet with his 42nd goal of the year.
Well, you know what, guys? Let's crank up that FSN time machine and take you back to the early 1990s when little Reed and Ty Loney, left and right on your screen, were just little guys when their father Troy was winning the Stanley Cup. Well, last night, those three were at it again. There's Troy on the bench for Pine Richland. There's a look at Reed Loney as the Rams defeated Bethel Park to win their third straight Penguins Cup title in their first in class AAA. Troy's an assistant coach, Reed's a senior, Ty also on the team. They're moving on to play in the state finals next week. Congrats to them. I know, Stag, you had a chance to call that game.
Yeah, it was really impressive. They have a kid named Brandon Sod, who was a freshman this year with Brian Richland, and it's going to be a kid to really keep your eye on. Maybe another one of those Pittsburgh developed players who ends up in the National Hockey League. He's a good one. He had a hat trick last night for Pine Ridgeland, and congratulations to all the winners.
Yeah, there's
Quaker Valley beating Mars. Greater La Trobe and Franklin Regional. La Trobe winning it.
Look at that cup.
And Pine Ridgeland beating Bethel Park. Penguins Cup for 2008. PIHL and 84 Lumber are sponsoring that. Tremendous work by a lot of people, you know, kind of really thankless work, Bob. A lot of volunteers, and you know what that's all about, being in minor hockey. Those people do it. It's a labor of love.
It is. They play for their schools. They play amateur hockey. And the kids are playing 70, 80 games, a lot of them this time of year, Staggy, which is a lot more than we played when we were kids. Maybe too much, to be honest with you. I think kids need time off in the summer. Find something else to do.
There's a quick shot and a save made by Fleury. We recently received an email from Dave Klasnick, who's been involved in hockey in the Mount Lebanon area and amateur hockey in this area for a long, long time. And he sent me a nice email about a little junket that they made to Russia just to study what they do over there, Bob. And they actually pay their coaches, but they make about $10,000 a year. And they're actually salaried employees who coached kids over there in Russia. And you were telling me in Canada they pay a lot more than that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they're making six figures up at that Bantam and Midget age and those traveling teams. Six figures, if you can believe it or not.
So that is not thankless work. That is. Here's Jordan Stahl, head manning to Marian Hossa. And Hossa tried to work the puck into the offensive zone, but the Lightning wouldn't let him do that. They dump it right back in and make a full change. Penguins are changing also. 8:13 to go in the second period. Evgeny Malkin's goal the difference as the Penguins lead 2-1. And a lead pass up the wing for St. Louis. He was wide open, but he couldn't take the pass off his skates. Break there for the Penguins, but Jokinen follows on. His shot, Fleury never saw it. It goes off the stick and up into the netting behind the Penguins' goal. Penguins clinging to a 2-1 lead.
Well, Hal, it's obviously in the second period, it's a tough change, and right there, that top line of Tampa Bay almost caught you guys on one.
Yeah, that's they have a pretty good goalie who moves it up quick, and those guys know when they're blowing the zone, so we have to be aware of that.
You know, you're coming out of a new club. Has it been easy to adjust, and how is it adjusting with your partner, Chris Letang?
I wouldn't say it's been easy. It's a different system, and there's different tweaks, but Letang has been great. He's an easy guy to play with. He's obviously got a lot of talent, so we're trying to use that as much as we can.
All right, thanks, and thanks for sitting down and not standing up during the interview.
A little easier that way.
All right, thank you.
He's still taller than me, Stag. He's sitting down.
Malkin to Sakura, and he rips one wide of the goal. That was a great slap shot, a one-timer by Sakura, just missed the net. And Sakura gets it back. Sakura throws it in front, and Malone trying to shoot it was poked away by goaltender Mike Smith. Here's this line again going to work, giving Lightning all they can handle, and LeCavalier finally works it out to center. Right wing pass for St. Louis just beyond his reach, and now he hauls it in, gets some help from Jokinen, back for St. Louis, off his stick and right to the goal, and Fleury makes the save.
Well, Mike Smith has got six assists in his career, and I asked Hal Gill about that change. Smith helps that puck up very quickly. Watch as the puck comes down, the Penguins are changing. Gill's trying to get on the ice for Orpik, but he's got to get back. And then St. Louis and LeCavalier always flying the zone, and especially so with Mike Smith back there. He learned a lot from Marty Turco in Dallas.
Speaking of Dallas, Jeff Halpern, the man acquired from the Stars along with Mike Smith, did not come out for the second period, so he's not playing right now for Tampa Bay, and that's a loss because he plays well against the Penguins, and he's been playing well lately for the Lightning since coming over in that deal.
Yeah, he had wrenched his body, Staggy, and he wasn't apparently was not healthy coming into the game. He wasn't able to take faceoffs for the last couple of games, and he'll be missed in this one for sure. I mean, he was supposed to check Malkin. Malkin has checked in with a goal.
Kennedy with a shot wide of the goal. And Whitney just took a solid body check from Junior Lessard deep in its own zone. No worse for wear. Lessard really rattled him into the boards.
I believe it was Lessard who got rattled by Rutu earlier in this game that led to the power play goal by the Lightning.
Now it's taken deep in the defensive zone by defenseman Matt Smaby. Smaby, a 6'5 defenseman. To the long for Mike Lundin, and he'll tap it out to center. Taken there by Hal Gill. Well, it's both a blessing and a compliment, I think, for Hal Gill to have played 3 years with Raymond Bourque in Boston. There's a shot by Connor James. It's blocked and taken now by Michelle Ouellette. Ouellette tried to center one. It goes off the skate of Menard. Good back check there by the Penguins as they break up the rush of the Lightning. Lightning will dump it in. Though Smaby shoots it in. Fleury anticipating quickly. Gets out to play the puck. Sweeps it away from Darche. But it comes right to Ouellette. Ouellette pokes it to the point. Picard with a heavy shot that sails wide of the glove of Fleury. And now to Hal Gill.
Yeah, and you mentioned Ray Bourque. Well, probably second only to Bobby Orr in terms of Bruin defenseman. Bobby Orr turns 60 today, Staggy, believe it or not. 60 years old. Bobby Orr, happy birthday.
Wow. And you know, Bob, you could say maybe that Bourque or the top two defensemen maybe in the history of the game. Certainly right up there in the top five.
No question.
And with Hal Gill playing 3 years as his partner, I mean, obviously it's a blessing, as I said, but I think it also says that, you know, Ray Bourque, if he didn't like the way Hal Gill played, he would just say, get me in somebody else as a partner. And he played 3 years with him. That tells you something about Hal Gill. There's a whistle, and we'll take a break. 5:05 to go. Hal Gill and the Penguins lead the Lightning 2-1.
Well, Vinny LeCavalier, he likes to anticipate, and the Penguins have their go-ahead goal because there's Janik with the puck. Where does LeCavalier go? He goes outside the blue line. Two players caught. The Penguins' Whitney keeps the puck in. There's an outman situation. Next thing you know, the puck is in the net behind Smith. So, yeah, sometimes you take the good with the bad. LeCavalier puts up the numbers, but you got to be mindful of your own zone, Stegi, and the puck wasn't over your blue line there. LeCavalier was.
That's why they talk also about how important it is. A chance for Stahl. Backhand shot stopped by Smith. You know, to get that first pass, Bob, to be able to make that outlet so that you get the puck out without having to go through what the Lightning went through there on that shift in their own zone.
I agree. They're missing Paul Ranger. You know, he's out with a shoulder injury. He got hurt in the third period of that Buffalo game, and they're going to miss him. He's a good defenseman.
Whitney made a nice play there, too, because he reached out with one hand on the stick and just lassoed that puck and then got it back to the goal. Now LeCavalier with it. Ahead for Jokinen, who turns and looks for the trailer. Instead, just dumps it rink wide. Danny Boyle moves it along for Shane O'Brien off his stick, and the Penguins will quickly counterattack. Stahl moves it to Dupuis. Dupuis has Stahl trailing, but Marian Hossa just ahead of the play offside as the Penguins enter the attacking zone. Pittsburgh Penguins hockey on FSN Pittsburgh is brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Visit us at geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO.
Well, only 11 shots on net for the Penguins, and Smith has seen a little bit more rubber here in Tampa than he did in Dallas. But they've done a pretty good job in front of them, Staggy. You know, Tampa have been allowing over 30 shots a game and slightly under that with Smith in the net, and he only saw 24 a game when he was in Dallas. And, of course, that shooting percentage of the Penguins, how good is that? Another 2 on 11 shots.
Exactly. They are second in the league in shooting percentage, tied with Montreal in that category. But I'll bet if you look at their home shooting percentage, and you really have to look at it, take the time to do it. We didn't have time before the game. We could check it out. But the Penguins have the second fewest number of shots on goal on home ice in the NHL, and yet they've scored a lot of goals. So I wouldn't be surprised at all. The Penguins are the best shooting percentage in the NHL on home ice, especially after ringing up 14 goals in two games. Here's Evgeny Malkin. He's got Whitney going to the net. Malkin drops it back instead for Sikora. Able to get it deep so that the Lightning couldn't counterattack on that high drop pass. Now Whitney will retreat. Boy, Malkin had Whitney cutting to the cage, but he just didn't feel as though he could get it through. He was hoping that Whitney would just take people with him to create an opening in the slot.
Well, he went with the odds, Staggy, and if you got Whitney there or you got Sikora open in the slot, you go with the odds. And Lemieux, if he had me going to the net or Brown in the slot, he would go to Rob Brown.
Talbot tries to one-time one. He fanned on that and went down, and now Letang steps to his right. Works it down deep. Talbot there, sandwiched by Kuba and Picard, two defensemen behind the net. Tyler Kennedy takes the puck. And Kennedy controls it nicely in traffic. Works it down low for Talbot. Kuba hammers him. And now it's Talbot again with it. Kennedy brought it free, but it is poked back to center ice by Carlson. It's going to trickle back into the Penguin zone. With 2:42 to go in the second period, the Penguins leading 2-1. Hal Gill sends it back around to the near side. A reverse move there up the wall for Jarkko Ruotsu. But it comes right back to Mike Lundin. He works it left side to LeCavalier, who feeds it to the corner. You see Jokinen in after it. Hal Gill cuts in front of him to take it away. Gill again reverses it that time. Cavalier read the play, but so do the Penguins on the centering pass. And both Talbot and Ruutu team up to make sure that puck gets out to center. Penguins want to make a line change here if they can. Hal Gill with it, and he gets a lot on it to get it back to the blue line. Hal Gill said something to me I thought was interesting. I said, what did you learn from Ray Bourque? He said, he told me to make every play hard, Bob. When you risk that puck, do it with authority. Don't make any cute plays when you're playing defense. Do everything hard. You saw what he did there. He fired it hard up the near wall to make sure he got it out.
And you know what makes it more difficult now, Staggy, just in that vein, is, you know, he would have liked to ice the puck there, but had he done that, he would have had to stay on the ice with the new rules. So, you know, he had to make kind of a slick neutral zone play instead of icing it all the way down.
Great observation. Here's Jordan Staal now behind the net. Staal peeling away and leaves it for Marian Hossa. Staal cycles back towards the net as Hossa makes a drop pass. Look at this. Penguins in that pinwheel offense now as Dupuis fires, and it's blocked right to the goal, and the save made by Mike Smith. A minute 25 to go in the period. And we look at our U.S. Marines point leaders.
Well, I know Malkin's got one because he's got the go-ahead marker in this hockey game. And look at the gap between one and two. If you look at the gap between one and two for the Pittsburgh Penguins, huge. 31 points, Staggy, if my math is correct. 31 points difference between Malkin and Crosby. The gap between the second and third leading scorer for Tampa is 43 points between St. Louis and Halpern. Actually, make it 44 with St. Louis' assist tonight. He's got 80 points. Halpern's the third leading scorer with 36.
Well, the Lightning certainly top-heavy in terms of their, you know, their elite players. And also in the terms of the money they're paid, Bob. And that's been a big subject. In Tampa. Tampa currently going through a transition here for new owners. They don't own the team yet, but they're involved in some of the decision making, including the decision to sign Dan Boyle to a long-term contract. Under a minute to go in the second period. Gonchar with it. And it's never easy for players or anybody in an organization when you're going through that kind of a change. There's a lot of uncertainty. You don't know if you're going to keep your job. And the players wonder what the new regime will bring in terms of the way that the club will be run. And as a result, it's sometimes difficult to win games. There are a lot of distractions, and I'm sure the Lightning would like to get that all taken care of so they can get back to the business of putting a good winning team on the ice.
Yeah, and one line's not going to win you a Stanley Cup. As I showed you in Hockey 101, you need two, and they won it when they had two strong lines, Tampa, with the Richards unit. And the Penguins, I believe, they're going to have they have at least two strong lines and definitely have a chance.
I think we all know what that's like in Pittsburgh, too, Bob. You know, having gone through the tough times we did with the bankruptcies and changes in ownership and Mario trying to get a new arena, and everything has just worked out so beautifully in Pittsburgh. It's never been better, really, as time expires here in the second period. So the Pittsburgh Penguins, on a goal by Evgeny Malkin, his 42nd of the season, have a 2-1 lead through two periods of play, and it's time to look at our Fort Pitt Capital by the numbers second period recap.
Well, they take a look at the one power play goal by Tampa, LeCavalier. But the Penguins have done a great job on their offensive forecheck, turned over a couple of biscuits, and gone ahead with the Malkin goal.
On an amazing shift, an indomitable shift by the Penguins that resulted in the goal. Ryan Whitney played a part in that. He'll talk to Dan in a moment. Paul Alexander in the studio. What you've missed also coming up during the intermission. Penguins lead it 2-1 as we go to the third. It'll be the same two guys who started the game in that center ice faceoff circle, Jordan Staal.
They're going to kick Jordan Staal out, no?
Against Vincent LeCavalier.
A lot of arguing going on right now.
And the Lightning control the opening faceoff of the third. Look at the shots. Only 12 for the Penguins, 14 for the Lightning.
Yeah, we talked about that with Mike Gill. The Penguins worked on defensive play yesterday. You know Tampa did. As Staal mishandles that puck going over the blue line, that's an offside. The Penguins worked on their defensive zone covered. The down low, the three-on-three down low. Defense being patient, being on the defensive side of pucks. They worked on trying to get back pressure, but knowing when to let go of that back pressure and pick up late man, like Kennedy failed to do on the goal by Avery when Jaromir Jagr set him up, Staggy. So they worked on a lot of defensive play yesterday.
You know, it's interesting what Mike Yeo had to say about not drawing penalties. There's something to keep in mind. Look out, a chance here as Smith fumbled the puck for a moment. Staal couldn't take advantage. But as I mentioned earlier, the Lightning have taken the second fewest number of penalties. There's a shot, score! Jordan Staal chops it into the goal as they turn it over in front of the net. And the Penguins make it 3-1.
Well, Mike Smith was just not awake to start this period. And once again, it's a third period blunder. He's not playing the puck here. Mike Sullivan, the assistant coach, looked over after that play, looked over to Tortorella and said, what was that? And then they turned the puck over again. Dupuis, with his quick speed, almost scores there. And Mike Smith out of position to play the second opportunity. And we've seen on all three Penguin goals that Mike Smith has been unable to make the second save. He's been out of position on all three Penguin goals.
And I'll tell you, Dan Boyle, who's a minus 17 coming into the hockey game, had a chance to rifle that puck out of danger, and it came right back to the front of the net. And Stahl took advantage and was able to pop it in. Another score! Sikora rips it into the goal! It's 4-1 Pittsburgh. The Penguins exploding again here early in the third period.
Well, you wouldn't even have known unless you saw it that Sikora scored. He didn't celebrate at all. The Steel City Lions on the board for the second time tonight. Malkin dangling with the biscuit. Look at that pass. I mean, it's an area pass. It's right in the wheelhouse of Sikora. In a one motion, he just goes five hole on Smith, who's moving. And I guess they will leave Smith in the net like they left Ramo in the net last night. And there's two quick goals by the Pens. And boy, some things just never change.
Two goals in 16 seconds. The Penguins have become an offensive juggernaut here at the Mellon Arena. Two straight seven-goal games. Now they explode for two more here early in the third, and an opportunity to blow the Lightning out here in this one if they can keep it going. But here's Picard. He shoots one wide of the goal. Kuba hustles over. Penalty coming up here. Smith's coming out of the net. They get the extra attacker on for one step, and then the whistle blows. So the power play coming up for Tampa Bay as Peter Sikora goes to the box. Sikora had gone, 24 games without taking a minor. I think that's his third or fourth penalty in the last four games.
It is. Yeah, it's four in the last five games for Sikora. You talked about home ice for Pittsburgh. They're 8-1-3 on home ice since the Crosby injury, Steggy, and 13-7-4 overall.
Amazing.
Yeah, it really is.
So many amazing things. We can't even count them. I mean, this hockey club, I don't even know that you can praise them enough, really, for how great they've been this year with all their injuries and the way they've been able to stick together as a club with new players coming up from Wilkes-Barre and right down through the organization. The Wilkes-Barre Scranton Penguins have won 9 in a row despite the fact that a lot of players were moved from that club up to this one. And everything just going so swimmingly for the Penguins right now in their organization.
Just put it in perspective a little bit. This is Tampa Bay, who gave up 7 last night against Buffalo, a team that's out of the playoffs.
Here's Kuba shooting, and he scores. Fleury was down on the play, and it was a wide open net. I don't know if the Flowers stumbled in the crease or what it was, but he was nowhere near the front of the net, and Kuba takes advantage to make it 4-2.
Well,
the,
you know, it was his right ankle that he hurt moving from left to right, and this is the motion he's going to have to make on this play. It's a goal-line-to-goal-line play. Let's see how he moves left to right. Very tough situation. As a goaltender, you tend to think it's not going to be that bad angle of shot. Now, Fleury moved out higher. Did you see how he pushed out more to the top of his crease instead of post to post? He was anticipating a pass that was more in the center of the ice. He was surprised when that pass was way across, Staggy, if you will, and he wasn't in position. He wasn't on the right angle to make the save.
Second power play goal of the night for the Lightning. So that gives them a nice little reprieve from the onslaught from the Penguins, and maybe a boost also as they'll psychologically at least feel like they're right back in this hockey game. Here's a shot by Gonchar off the end boards, taken behind the net, swung in front by Rutu, broken up by Shane O'Brien, and now cleared by Darsh up the wall. Ouellette reaches for it, but it comes back to Penguin defenseman Brooks Orpik. Out on left wing for Jarkko Rutu. Right to the goal, and Smith again. Now we've seen goalies who handle the puck a lot. Every now and then they'll make blunders. They'll give it away. They'll create opportunities for themselves to make saves. But they also can make a lot of good plays to help out their defense. So it's kind of a double-edged sword at times.
You're right, Steg. You know, it's not too often. Both these goals by Tampa where you see such wide, long passes from east to west, from side to side, both the LeCavier goal and the Kuba goal, very difficult for a goaltender, not expecting the pass to carry that kind of distance east to west.
It was really, as I was saying, when those goals were scored, we were rudely interrupted by the explosion by the Penguins. Two goals in 16 seconds is that I was kind of surprised Mike Yeo said the Penguins weren't moving their feet, because it seemed to me that some of their shifts were really long. They were shifts in which they could have drawn penalties but didn't, and then ended up scoring goals. So it's kind of one or the other, isn't it, sometimes? But I just thought the Penguins really had some great shifts through the first two periods. Well, the Penguins' franchise record of consecutive sellouts growing by the game. Don't be left out. Join the Penguins season ticket waiting list. Visit PittsburghPenguins.com for complete details and reserve your spot today.
Now, Dino's back on the ice. He's checking the skates out. A little sharpening job. I don't see Dana on the bench, so. No, there he is down at the end. Maybe Paul DeFazio was working on something. Evgeny Malkin, a little equipment-wise.
Danny Boyle works it near side. Like Saint-Louis tried to center. Stahl broke it up. Now it's a lead pass. Reaching forward is Marian Hossa. Hossa for Dupuy. Oh, Stahl is there. Oh, Smith with a sprawling save on Jordan Stahl. He was right there. Stahl had scored two goals earlier this year against the Lightning in Tampa. He almost had a second one there. He's not going to get a much better chance on a perfect setup on the doorstep.
And we talk about goaltenders having to move. Look, Smith's got to move a long way, but he's got big, long legs. And it looked like Stahl was going to bury one on the big goaltender. No, denied right there. And not since John Graham have the Tampa Bay Lightning have such a big, lanky goaltender.
Thing was generating a couple of goals earlier in this game on the grind, and now the goal from Sikora off the rush. Malone with a shot, and almost another one there from Stahl off the rush. Now it's Kuba with it. Now for Ouellette. Ouellette has a man going to the net. Darsh shoots the puck off the blocker of Fleury to the near side. Picard sends it around the horn. Malone over for it. So is Kuba. Kuba can't keep it in. Squirts back to center. He almost gave it away to Malkin, but finds Alex Picard. And he just whips it all the way to the goal where Daryl Sador will take it.
Long way to go in this hockey game. It's a two-goal game. Over 15 minutes left on the clock. Tampa's not going to give up anything here right now if they can help it.
Ryan Whitney goes to the bench as Ryan Malone has the puck on the wall. Works it to the corner for Malkin. Malkin has a man going to the net. Sikora instead tried to feed it to Malone. Snaps it all the way out to center.
Yeah, Sador was changing on the play. It was a great change at the time, but the forwards didn't realize it. By the time Gilgate got out on the ice, he was 10 feet from the blue line.
Shane O'Brien moves it to the right side. Boyle wires it the length of the ice. Fleury will stop it behind the goal.
You hear a lot down here between the benches, Staggy, and you know, a lot of those things where a guy gets a pass in the neutral zone, the players are yelling, heads up, always looking out for one another, protecting one another, yelling when to pass a puck, yelling when to change, you know, yelling at referees, yelling at players on the other team. You really don't pick that up when you're way up top. And there is Evgeny Malkin, 99 points on the season, 99.
Penguins keep filling the net like they are at home, and Malkin will keep putting pressure on Alexander Ovechkin at the top of the scoring list. There's another chance. Oh, and Stahl almost had another one of the trickling off the shoulder of Mike Smith. Now LeCavalier trying to get it out. Gets his body turned around. Looks for a lead pass. Off the boards it goes. Back and behind the Penguins goal to Orpik, and it's an icing call. They'll bring it all the way back into the Lightning zone.
Well, he does remind me of John Graham. He handles the puck better than John Graham did, but he reminds me of Graham in the net, because Graham used to always drop down on his knees, try to get the body in the way. Smith, once again, does drop down onto the knees. He gets the right shoulder on that Stahl redirect. Well, Sikora had a sore back. He missed practice yesterday. He's getting a little work on the bench. A little massage. And Sikora, maybe that's why he didn't celebrate on the goal stay. He didn't want to throw that back out of kilter.
Well, for a guy with a bad back, he's sure putting up some big numbers.
Yeah, he really is. A tremendous season for Sikora. You have to go back to when he was a member of the A-line in New Jersey when he had 35. Kind of production. The Penguins are going to find themselves in the penalty box. Ruutu once again goes in. He's pleading his case with Dvorsky right now. If you look at Peter Sikora, his numbers in the last six games with his goal tonight.
And he said in the article that was written today in the paper, as Ruutu goes over and ties the man up, got the free hand spinning LeCavalier around, and he takes the penalty. Bob, he was with that A-line for 4 years. He's really only been on this unit for 30 games. But he's having a lot of fun playing with Evgeny Malkin and Ryan Malone. Holding the call on Jarkko Ruotu and the Lightning, who have two power play goals in this game on six shots, four opportunities, can make it a 4-3 hockey game right here and a completely different complexion to this game if they can score. And Ouellette is a dangerous power play specialist. Keep your eye on him. The right-hand shooter, number seven. Orpik pushes a man from behind. That was Boyle, and the Penguins get the puck back to center.
Yeah, well, that's got five power play goals on the season. LeCavier and St. Louis, nine apiece.
Now Kuba drops it off. Ouellette playing in his 56th game. He missed a ton of games with a shoulder injury. Now the bouncing puck, and the Lightning will keep it in. Kuba sends it to the corner. Led over to play, and it was pushed right by him by Gonchar to the corner, and Orpik keeping those feet moving, able to get to the loose puck and shoot it down the ice.
Good old-fashioned hard work on the penalty kill for Pittsburgh, using the wall to their advantage.
Now it's Alex Picard to pass off his skate. Letang able to work it back to center ice. Stahl trying to pry it free, and he does. Stahl's had a strong game again. He's been a monster in a lot of games. Never mind the goals. There's so many things he does well, including kill penalties, and he's able to find Malone here. Kuba checking Malone, who protects the puck in the corner with 34 seconds to go on the penalty to Jarkko Ruotu. And the fans loving the penalty killing of Ryan Malone as Alex Picard lugs that puck for the Lightning. Now to LeCavalier off his stick and dumped right back in by Marian Hossa. And you can hear the crowd. They're enjoying this penalty-killing effort by the Penguins. 17 seconds to go on the penalty. Picard finds Shane O'Brien. O'Brien gains the attacking zone, drops it back, held in by Picard, but he gave it away. And a chance here for Hossa. A two-on-one with Talbot, with Picard back. Hossa to Talbot. The shot. Great save by Smith as he stacked his pads to stop Maxime Talbot.
That was a sick pass by Hossa as well. What a saucer pass onto the tape of Talbot.
Here goes Saint-Louis busting in. He's going to try to get to Sador first, but Darryl able to get to the puck. Penalty over. Great penalty kill by the Penguins. They almost scored a shorty. Now it's Sikora. Sikora pulls up, looks for Malkin, knocks it out of midair, gets to the puck, shoots. Stopped. Now it comes right back to Malone. He'll drop it off. Gill with a shot. Group traffic to Malone. Right to Sikora to Malkin. And he hit the goalpost. Out of the near side, the Lightning try to get it out, and it's worked out by Tarnaski. Letang stands tall in the neutral zone to make sure they can't get it around him. And Sikora at the blue line able to force it back inside the Lightning zone. This line is creating all kind of problems for the Lightning in their own end. Now it's Junior Lessard moving it out for Nick Tarnaski. Gill with a sweep check on him, and he holds him off to get back to the puck. One hands it around behind the net. Craig McDonald there for Tampa Bay. Centers, and it goes right past Lessard. All the way back into the Lightning zone.
Ryan Malone will complete the change. Malkin comes off as well. That close to point 100. That close.
Mike Lundin of the Lightning. Headmans the puck. It goes the length of the ice. Fleury will set it up for Sergei Gonchar. And Gonchar moves it out on left wing to Chris Menard. Menard finds Brooks Orpik. Nice lead pass up the right wing to Connor James. James pulls up, looks for a trailer, and instead dumps it down the wall for Jeff Tate. Tate to the goal shot. Great save again by Smith as Gonchar sneaked in from the back door. Now they work it out of the corner. James and Menard. Menard behind the net, overskates the puck. James trying to get to it. He's hit by number 32, Matt Smaby, and the puck to the near corner. James after it again, but Andreas Carlson finds Picard. And Alex Picard moves it out on the left side to Janik. Doug Janik playing on the blue line, shoots the puck up to the net, and a save made by Fleury. Janik, a defenseman, they used 7D here tonight. They lost Jeff Halpern. And a rare shift for him. He goes back to the bench as the Lightning cycle the puck. And it's cleared by the Penguins. It goes all the way back into the Lightning zone with 10:07 to go in the hockey game.
Look,
Penguins
at Hossa
leading by two.
You see that speed on Hossa trying to track down that puck. Smith had to come out and help his defenseman out. The Penguins, they're getting great chances around the net. They're going to have to find the five hole or go upstairs on Smith. He's got those long limbs.
And Smith falls down, hauls the puck back in, and almost lost it to a Penguin with a wide open net. Here's Stahl with it, shoots, saved, and they're blocked in front. Comes all the way back to the point. Whitney dumps it back in deep. Hossa turns his back on the defender, but it comes free to Dan Boyle. Works it up the wall for Jussi Jokinen. He finds Saint-Louis in center. LeCavalier moving ahead. And they move it to the right side instead of Jokinen. And LeCavalier goes to the net, drop past Saint-Louis. He finds Kuba, fires it high and wide off the glass. To the near side, Picard. He'll work it in behind the net for LeCavalier for Jokinen. It went off the side of the cage. Saint-Louis upended. Gets back up and works into the corner for LeCavalier, who turns his back on Stahl and knocks him down. Kuba with a shot just wide of the goal again. Kuba missing the net on some opportunities.
And he hit the net on one.
He did. And it was a wide open net, too. If he'd have missed that, if he'd have missed that one, he would have wanted to go see a psychiatrist. Now an icing call against Pittsburgh. 4-2 Pittsburgh with 8:58 to go.
Well, Jordan Stahl has got his hands full with number four, Vinny LeCavalier, in the last shift. Vinny saw him coming, and he got the big butt out. Oh. And down went Stahl.
Oh, man.
He saw him coming. And there was a lot of conversation between the benches at the last whistle. Vinny just looked over and peacefully went to his bench. Look at his career against Pittsburgh with his goal and assist tonight. He was shut out in the three previous meetings this season between the two clubs.
Lightning trying to get another one. Darsh to the goal. He lost the puck, though. Penguins have it in their own zone, and it is Dupuis slogging his way up the near wall. Following on is Hossa. Hossa getting himself open, delaying and shooting, and a blocker save made by Smith. Boy, Hossa buying time and space for himself there.
He's sneaky. He's got that sneaky shot. That's how he scored his only goal for Pittsburgh. Just a quick shot. He usually likes to go blocker side or very low.
Now Fleury stops it behind the goal. A two-goal lead for the Penguins. They exploded for two goals in 16 seconds at the beginning of this third period. And then the Lightning came back with a power play goal by Philip Kuba to make it 4-2.
A pair of power play goals for the Lightning tonight against a Penguin power play unit that's been very, very efficient on home ice.
Now it's Malkin swooping down the wing, drops it off. Letang in front of shot, and a good save again by Smith on Ryan Malone. Smith has made three great saves off the rush in this period. The Penguins could have six or seven goals on the board already.
Oh, I know. They have 18 shots, but half of them glorious.
Sikora with a drive, and another unconscious save that time by Mike Smith. Out to Sikora again, to Gonchar. A shooting gallery right now for Mike Smith. Here's the shot again by Gonchar. And he moves it to the near corner to Sikora. Sikora cross ice. And poked to the corner by Gonchar to Malone. And here we go again. These guys just creating opportunity after opportunity in the great puck possession game in the offensive zone. Finally, the Lightning are able to work it back to center. Marty Saint-Louis. This is happening at times against their top line, too, Bob. You mentioned that earlier. But not only are the Penguins generating offense, but they're keeping that line deep in their own zone.
Yeah, and that line does not want to play in their own zone. You know that. I know that. They cheated a couple of times in this hockey game, and the Penguins have made them pay.
Tarnaski with a shot. Kicked away by Fleury to the corner. Junior Lessard has it. Works it in front. Now to LeCavalier, to Lundin. Fumbles the puck. Ruutu takes off. There'll be a penalty. Ruutu kicking the puck along. He has Kennedy with him. Passes the puck. Backhand shot. Great save by Smith on Maxime Talbot with a right pad after Ruutu played soccer for 45 feet. Some of the fans are giving him a standing ovation. They absolutely love it. Yarko Ruutu has played a major role in this game here tonight.
And look at him dribble, Steggy.
Are chilies essential ingredients for putting this game in the belly?
Yeah, well, pedal to the metal, keep it going, and attention to detail for the Penguins. And how about a little more Yarko Ruutu dribbling that puck from skate to skate? And this is what young players do, but not in NHL hockey games, Staggy. Sometimes, you know, you get your young kids on the ice and you line them up and you have them do that just to control the puck in hockey school. But to do that in an NHL hockey game and with the ease in which Yarko Ruutu did that, that was something. And Whitney came over, his eyes were wide open, and went over to Ruutu. He said, that was unbelievable. And Ruutu had no expression at all.
No, he acted like it was just another play I made as I went up the ice. And Maxime Talbot came within an inch of scoring the goal. And if he had, that would have been one for the ages right there. Ryan Malone, he'll still show the replay, but it won't have the same effect as it would have if Talbot would have scored. The Penguins on a power play. Lundin in the box. Penguins are 0-for-1, only their second power play chance. And Malkin controls the puck. Penguins lead it 4-2. This goal here, a goal here, would be gigantic for the Penguins. As it is just a two-goal game, and it could be a lot worse for the Lightning. Here's Malkin faking the shot. Wrists it down low off a stick. Mike Smith has been sensational since allowing that fourth goal. He stopped Jordan Staal twice. He's made some saves through traffic. He made that save on Talbot. And I believe he made a good save on Sikora, too, if I'm not mistaken. So he's made at least four great saves here since he allowed that fourth goal. Now back around for the near side. Ryan Malone crashing in. Malkin keeps it alive. It squirts free. Gonchar kicks it down the board. Tries again, but this time it comes out to center. And a little pass ahead to Matthew Darche. Darche with a shot off a leg. Whitney takes it off the Karam. Dishes it up the board. Saint-Louis hustles for the loose puck and is able to shoot it back into his own zone. Hawkins going to come after with Mike Smith out of the net. Smith quickly moves it along. And Shane O'Brien slaps it down the ice. 30 seconds to go on the penalty to defenseman Mike Lundin of the Lightning.
Well, here comes Darryl Sador, won a cup with the Tampa Bay Lightning, as well as Dana Heinze, equipment manager.
Sador slaps it in. Smith can't stop it. Kuba can't clear it. Held in for Letang. Letang wanted to tee it up, but it got away from him. He'll get it back. Great skating by Letang. Letang works it down low. Ends up on the far wall, and Sador hustles over to make sure it stays in. Tafe let it go behind the net to Sikora. Penalty over. Lundin comes on. Letang pinches. Works it behind the net for Tyler Kennedy to Sikora. Letang backs off now. Puck stays in the offensive zone, though. LeCavalier knocking it out of midair. Tyler Kennedy won't let him get it out. Amazing.
Everybody's using their foot. Tafe just used his foot, and the puck was in the air. Gonchar, we saw him kicking the puck on the Penguins' power play, and, of course, the Ruutu display. Everybody's trying to get into the act.
Staal was just upended on a knee by LeCavalier, and LeCavalier's hurting on that.
Yes, he is.
And Staal was the one who was kneed on the play, but it was by LeCavalier who's flexing that right leg. There was no penalty on the play. It could have been kneeing on LeCavalier.
And it was those two that collided earlier, the butt of LeCavalier on Staal.
Now Tarnaski overskated the puck, but Shane O'Brien follows on and busts into the attacking zone, moves it left wing to Andreas Karlsson. Behind the net for Staal. And Staal looks up, feeds it ahead on the left wing to Jarkko Ruutu. He has a man behind the defense. Dupuy, and a save made. Rebound, Ruutu slaps it wide of the goal. My goodness, the chances the Penguins have had off the rush here in the third period.
Ruutu just lofted that puck at the Tampa defense, who couldn't play it. Dupuy got in behind, had another glorious opportunity.
Staal again, inside-outside move. Now he'll turn away, look for a trailer. Throws it in the net, deflected wide of the goal by Ruutu. Ruutu takes it again. Jarkko Ruutu playing a strong game. And Ruutu has gotten a lot of ice time lately, 10 minutes or more in 11 of the last 17 games. That's saying a lot, because there were a lot of games where he had 5, 6, 7 minutes earlier in the year. But with the injuries, Ruutu has been elevated from a fourth line to a third line, and he's taking advantage of it. Now Matthew Darche in the near corner of his own zone. And Darche sends it back to the corner. Now for Darche again to Picard. Sikora bothering him. Staal in there also, keeping the puck to the outside. Sikora in his own zone, able to get it back to center with 2:43 to go. Ryan Malone on the forecheck. Picard looks up, headmans the puck. And Bob, with the Penguins getting the chances they are off the rush, that would tell me that, again, the Lightning are not doing a particularly good job of clogging up the neutral zone. They're backing in, allowing the Penguins, like they are right now. Another chance towards the goal of Malone. Cutting to the net. Turning shot by Sikora blocked. O'Brien able to work at the center and no further. Gonchar's got it, and he'll go right back to work in the offensive zone. Smith can't stop it. Malkin backhands it into the slot. LeCavalier back from that bump on the knee, moves it out to center and is knocked right back in by Connor James.
Well, they're giving up opportunities. They're down by two goals. There's 2 minutes left on the clock, and the defensemen are going to have to go and watch Boyle right now. Here he goes.
And the lead pass to Gonchar. Gonchar turns it back, and out to center it goes with a minute 50 remaining in the game.
So LeCavalier's back on after that collision with Staal, which he looked like he wrenched his knee.
Maxime Talbot takes off. He's got Tafe with him. Talbot drops it off for Gonchar. Comes off a stick. Tafe with a shot wide on the glove side of Smith. Now it's Al Gill, and he'll wrist it in deep again. Tafe will take it in the corner. And the Penguins start that cycling game again. Connor James with great energy leaves it in the corner for Max Talbot. Back for James. James looks for Tafe on the left wing boards. He'll send it right back into the corner for Connor James. Ouellette on him. Talbot comes in, turns his back to Ouellette. Talbot keeping it behind the cage. Finally, it is the defenseman Philip Kuba leaving it for his partner Alex Picard with a minute 11 to go in the hockey game. They want to get Smith off.
And here he goes.
And here come the Lightning with the extra attacker on. It's Andreas Karlsson to the near wall. He dumps it in behind the net. Darsh is there. Letang trying to get it away from him. Turning with it now. Moving it out of the point is Lessard. A save made by Fleury. Loose puck. St. Louis with a backhander and a save made by Fleury on his knees, and he covers it up. Good chance for St. Louis as he was kind of drifting away from the net. He almost sneaked that one in on the short side.
Time for our Subway sandwich of the game. These two men have met a couple of times in this third period. Le Cavalier, the butt side hit on Stahl. He definitely saw him coming. And it looks like Tampa will call their timeout with 51.8 left on the clock. John Tortorella. Looking, let's see who he looks to. Vinny Le Cavalier took a short, brief shift his last time he was on the ice after looked like he wrenched his knee about 5 minutes ago.
Well, you got to play to the buzzer or the horn here at Mellon Arena, Bob, and that's what the Lightning will be doing. Down by two, they'll have an empty net, a face-off in the Penguin zone, and what will their strategy be?
And well, you know, the face-off is on the left side, to the left side of Marc-Andre Fleury. So if LeCavier's taking the draw, he'll probably try to go to the boards with it, Steggy. It makes it easier if a left-handed shooter can go to the wall with that face-off. And we'll see if he does that. St. Louis, a left-handed shooter, he could come around the top of the circle, or he could feed it back to Boyle. And we'll see exactly what LeCavier does. I believe he will probably try to win it board side to St. Louis.
St. Louis right there is posted up on the right wing.
Although he's
board.
Got his hand turned backwards, but he trick played it. He had his hand turned backward on the draw, but he went forward with it.
And St. Louis ends up with it, yep. And LeCavalier throws it to the net, and it comes right to the near side. Poked right back to Kuba, drive. Save made by Fleury. The rebound, Darsh poking at it. Still loose in the net. And a scrum around the goal. Fleury trying to keep it out, and he does. The puck doesn't go in as Fleury sits down on top of it. A mad scramble in front of the net for that loose puck.
I don't know how that puck stayed out. Jackson had a good view, and it didn't get it. Let's take a look at the faceoff. You can look at Vinny's hand. It's turned backwards, but he goes forward, and St. Louis jumps on that. And they get possession of the puck, and here's the scramble in front of the net. And they just try to push the pad of Fleury over the goal line. And Orpik helps out once again like he did with Conklin the other night, keeping Fleury's pad above that goal line.
And what an interesting way to win a draw, Bob. St. Louis knew exactly where he was going to get to that puck.
Well, we've seen him shoot. Remember when he did a couple of years ago, Staggy? Le Cavalier turned the hand over and actually shot the puck that way?
This time he pulls it back to Kuba with 32 seconds to go. Sent back around. Le Cavalier head faking. And now Malkin just rifles the puck down the ice for the empty net. Kuba back to it. And he touches it for an icing call. And you can make that play when you're up by two.
Yeah. 25 seconds left. And Gino gave it a shot for the empty net. He has two empty net goals already this year against Tampa. He's looking for a third. Let's see what Vinny has in store now. Look at it. He's talking right now to St. Louis, letting him know exactly what he wants to do. And he's looking around, and he goes the same way.
Penguins with 11 shots here in the third period as we get down to 11 seconds in the game. And they must have had five or six great scoring opportunities. Le Cavalier shoots, deflected wide. And there's Malkin, 3 seconds to go with an empty net. Malkin moves to the middle. He's got a man open. It's Hossa. He doesn't get the goal, though. The green light went on before he shot it. He took one extra stride before he shot the puck. And I don't believe he'll get the goal, but the Penguins will win it by a score of 4-2. And Marc-Andre Fleury will get the win. What a third period for the Pittsburgh Penguins, scoring two goals in 16 seconds and then absolutely getting one great chance after another against Mike Smith. We'll be back in just a moment to summarize this big win for the Pens.